Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who never cease to bestow the glory of holiness on the faithful servants you raise up for yourself, graciously grant that the Holy Spirit may kindle in us that fire with which you wonderfully fill the heart of St. Philip Neri, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. From Miletus, Paul had the presbyters of the church at Ephesus summoned. When they came to him, he addressed them. You know how I lived among you the whole time, from the first day I came to the province of Asia. I served the Lord with all humility, and with the tears and trials that came to me because of the plots of the Jews. And I did not at all shrink from telling you what was for your benefit, or from teaching you in public in your own homes. I earnestly bore witness for both Jews and Greeks to repentance before God and to faith in our Lord Jesus. But now, compelled by the Spirit, I am going to Jerusalem. What will happen to me there I do not know, except that in one city after another, the Holy Spirit has been warning me that imprisonment and hardships await me. Yet I consider life of no importance to me, if only I may finish my course and the ministry that I received from the Lord Jesus, to bear witness to the gospel of God's grace. But now I know that none of you to whom I preached the kingdom during my travels will ever see my face again. And so I solemnly declare to you this day, that I am not responsible for the blood of any of you, for I did not shrink from proclaiming to you the entire plan of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
A bountiful rain you showered down, O God, upon your inheritance. You restored the land when it languished. Your flock settled in it. In your goodness, O God, you provided it for the needy. Blessed day by day be the Lord who bears our burdens, God who is our salvation. God is a saving God for us. The Lord, my Lord, controls the passageways of death.
Yes, I got one. Thank you. All right, so we are, of course, in this Pentecost arena, praying for an outpouring of the Holy Spirit. And so, in the perhaps in the spirit of St. Philip Neri, who was filled indeed, as the opening prayer reminds us, with that fire of the Holy Spirit. You know, he had experienced at one point in his life where he was so filled with the love of God that his heart really caused him a lot of pain, and doctors examining him after his death say that his heart was actually enlarged more than normal. So the love of God came in such a powerful way that it actually changed his heart physiologically. Quite remarkable. But anyway, he was certainly filled with love and joy. So perhaps by his inspiration today, I don't know, I rather thought that the readings remind me of how the life of a Christian is kind of like a game of hot potato. We all played hot potato at some point, I assume, right? We got to pass the potato on so that you don't get stuck with it when the music ends. Well, in a sense, that is our mission, the mission of the gospel. St. Paul is talking here to the presbyters at Ephesus, and he says, "You're never going to see me again." So what's my final word, my final message to you? Well, he says, I'm not guilt responsible for the love of any of you. Like, I passed it all on to you. I got rid of it as quickly as I could, you know, right? St. Paul certainly had that sense that to proclaim the gospel is urgent. I can't hold the potato. I've got to pass it on. Because indeed, Jesus said very clearly, we have received from him the word. He says in the gospel today, the words you gave to me, Father, I have given to them, and they accepted them and truly understood. See, this is what we want. We have received that word of God, and we want to receive it and truly understand it. But it becomes, once we have received it, with the burning power of the Holy Spirit, like that hot potato, we've got to pass it on, because if the Lord comes back and we still got the potato, he's going to be like, why didn't you pass it on? That was the whole idea, right? And, but of course, now, you know, we say that, but if you play the game hot potato, you know, sometimes if you try to pass on too hastily, it gets dropped. And then, you know, it's like spinning around the floor, and everybody's diving for it. You might even know you could dive for it, because who wants the hot potato? But the point is, if somebody doesn't pick it up, then the person who dropped it, which was you, is going to get called out by everybody and be the one who loses anyway, right? So that's the idea. Sometimes, of course, we do have to be careful about We humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." His wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance of your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Philip Neri, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Roger Joseph, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the same peace I give.